I want to start right now with the Pulse of Steeler Nation. Whew. I don't want to mess around. They're 3-0. I'm going right to the Pulse of Steeler Nation, reacting to their win over the Chargers for the home opener on Sunday. 3-0 Steelers. Let's go right to Crazy Italian Guy with the Steeler Nation reaction.
All is officially here. We just won the first game in AccuSure this season. Life is beautiful. 3-0
Yeah.
Steelers! Yeah.
Yeah. That is Nate, the Crazy Italian Guy, here on the 96.1 Kiss Morning Freak Show.
Life
Pulse of Steeler Nation.
Beautiful!
Man, you know Steelers are doing good when you're waving the terrible towel, just yelling, first day of fall, life is beautiful!
Fall is officially here!
Yep.
We just won the first game at AccuSure this season!
It's fall.
Life is beautiful! 3-0
Yep.
Steelers!
Oh, yeah. Life is beautiful. Life is beautiful. 3-0 Steelers. And then we check the Facebook comments, though, right? We still got a round of Steelers Facebook comments, even though they're 3-0 and one of the best teams in the NFL clearly right now, right?
Oh, we still got them.
Oh, man. All right.
Yeah.
We got a round of Steelers Facebook comments coming up around 7:40 this morning, and your chance to win some sold-out Billie Eilish tickets around 7:55. Good morning!
Steelers!
Hey, what do we use for Justin Fields, Steelers quarterback? I forgot. What do we use for him when we play clips of him on the show? Because he's sort of very monotone and, you know, what is it, dude? What
I
do we play?
Crazy Frog.
Dude,
isn't
Crazy
it?
Frog. That's what it was.
He started using Crazy Frog.
The Axel F thing. The whole, yeah. This. That's right.
Yep,
okay.
Yep.
All right. Well, here we go. After the Steelers start the season 3-0, beating the Chargers in the home opener 20-10, here was Steelers quarterback Justin Fields on if he's proven people wrong.
I'm not really worried about that. I'm more so into proving, you know, myself, you know, right. I know, you know, what kind of player I am. You know, I haven't changed kind of my whole life, so. At the end of the day, my teammates helped me be great. So shout out to them. Shout out to our defense. Shout out to everybody else on the offense for pushing me each and every day at practice. And, you know, it's just a credit to them. So I'm definitely, you know, glad and just feeling good to be in this position, to be honest with you. So.
Oh, man.
Feeling good.
It's way too early to be this stupid. Seriously, it's way too, like, we're both in here smiling and just vibing to Crazy Frog as Justin Fields talks about the game. Justin Fields was asked, you know, hey, the offense was sort of stagnant in the first half. What happened in the second half to sort of turn the offense around?
We knew what kind of game we were going to be in.
Oh, yeah.
And we knew that we didn't play well enough in the first half. We knew we were better than that, so... You know, Coach T challenged us at halftime to play better and be better. And we came out second half and did just that. So.
Oh, yeah, you did. Ding, 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 ding. Man, I can't do the is Justin Fields the guy though. I can't do this after.
But is he the guy?
No, we can't do is he the guy.
Is he?
Oh God, sports talk radio. What do you think? Is he a guy? No,
this has gotta be getting better. I mean, Justin's still the guy.
No, I can't do that. No, I can't do that today. What we're gonna do today is read some Steelers Facebook comments because even though they won, even though they have started the season 3-0.
Yeah.
And it's not just 3-0. It's the kind of winning that, like, old Steeler fans should love. Defense.
All defense.
Run a ball.
Nasty.
Protect the ball.
Big nasty D.
It's not like we're throwing for 400 yards or something. This is your papaw's grand and pond Steelers right here, right?
It is.
All right, let's get to one of your talkback messages here again. If you got anything Steelers related or otherwise for us on the show this morning, you can simply download our free iHeartRadio app, and when you're streaming 96.1 Kiss or the Mikey and Bob podcast, you just hit that little microphone and send us a talkback message brought to us by One Team Media.
Bob, I don't know how you do it.
Huh?
I just tried. I went to the Steelers Facebook comments.
Oh, no.
Oh, man.
Listen, we should almost throw a warning out before we read a round of Facebook comments that reading the Facebook comment section is not for the faint of heart, right?
Like, not great.
You can't be an amateur doing that. You got to be a professional or it's going to mess with you.
There's like 2,000 comments in there.
Is that usually what it is? Like after a Steelers game on their Facebook page, is it like 2,000?
I mean, it depends what time you go there. It can be like 2,000. It can be 10,000.
Oh, okay, really?
Depends on how they play.
Okay, got it. All right. Know? Man, you have to sift through thousands of comments just scrolling and scrolling and looking for good ones for the show. Yeah.
You've been doing this for years.
Yeah.
I have no idea how you've kept your sanity for this long. It's insane.
Has he, though? Has Bob kept his sanity over the...
No. Am I sane at all?
He laughs like the Joker. I think we've made him insane, right?
Look what you've done to me.
This is what it is. We've beaten him down by making him read Facebook comments and collect Facebook comments after Pittsburgh sports wins or losses.
Yeah, so all your life will always be better if you just stay out of the Facebook comments.
Bob, it's all about them Steelers this morning. We have a 3-0 football team, Pittsburgh, after the Steelers get the win in the home opener, beating the Chargers 20-10. Justin Fields looks like a competent quarterback. He threw for 245 yards, a touchdown to Calvin Austin the third, that 55-yarder where Calvin Austin's like, oh, I got it, and then meow! And then one interception too, which kind of sucks because that's his first turnover, first interception of the year. And it was sort of like, you know, the
got
ball
knocked around.
Yeah, like, you know, I mean, it is your fault if you're a quarterback and it hits somebody's hand and then goes, but, you know, still, he has been playing very smart football. And let's get to Coach Tomlin. And listen, we're not just going to play the post-game clips of Coach Tomlin like everybody else does. No, we like to slow Coach Tomlin down.
Get a little sexy with it.
Make him sensual, Tomlin. So here he was after the game talking about the win against the Chargers.
You know, we talked about it all week. We knew we were in for a fight. They're assembled like we're assembled. Mm-hmm. And so we knew it was going to be an entertaining game. It was a fight, though, man. These guys are obviously well-coached in a talented group.
Oh, yeah, they are. Here was Coach Tomlin just talking about the team staying in the game to win it. Because that first half was rough. Like, that first half, the offense wasn't,
just
you know, moving the ball.
Yeah.
And then, you know, staying in the game and winning it in the second half.
It didn't happen instantly. We had to, you know, we had to stay in it. But that's life, and definitely life in the NFL.
All up
but I didn't feel any blink or anybody running away from the challenge. I just felt guys leaning in on the challenge. And
no blinking at all, man, right? Got to stay in it. Stay in it.
Living up in it.
Keep those eyes open. Stay in it. Do not blink. Here was Coach Tomlin talking about Steelers quarterback Justin Fields and how he performed.
He's doing an awesome job doing what we're asking him to do, playing and playing to win.
Mm.
And so that's appreciated.
Staying in it. Not blinking.
Mm-mm.
Direct eye contact.
Ho, ho.
That's how you know it's love right there.
Uh-huh.
Direct eye contact. And then Coach Tomlin was just saying that there's a nakedness to the NFL. Is
full
that,
naked, low naked.
Towards the end of the press conference, he went full nudity with this. All right, here he is, sensual Tomlin.
There's a nakedness in this business at this level.
Yeah.
There's nowhere to hide.
Yep.
When you got a challenge like that walking in your venue,
mm-hmm.
You better fight.
Naked. At Acrisure.
Nowhere to hide.
Ho-ho!
What's going on here?
There's a nakedness in this business at this level.
Man. NFL. The N stands for nudity. I think he's basically just saying, though, like, you can't hide. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, everybody knew that Justin Fields was going to have to beat the Chargers. They were going to stack up against the run. That's what happened in the first half.
Yeah.
And then Justin Fields sort of went out there and won the game. I think that was the nakedness to the NFL. It's like, we know what you're good at. Mm. We're going to try to stop you. And
the Naked Football League.
Oh,
ooh,
man.
Damn.
maybe we were ahead of the game on this whole sensual Coach Tomlin thing here. So Steelers get the win 20-10 against the Chargers. Next week, they will go to Indianapolis, right? Take on the Colts.
Yep.
So third road game in the first four games of the season, which means you know that the back end of this schedule is all home games when we, you know, might need them. And you know, who wants to come to Pittsburgh in the fall and winter and play Grounded Pond? Grounded Pond Steeler football.
Naked Grounded Pond.
There's a nakedness in this business at this level.
There's a nakedness to the ground and pond. Steelers!
Steelers!
It's Mikey and Bob, the 96.1 Kiss Morning Freak Show. All about them Steelers this morning. 3-0 on the season now after they get the home opening win against the Chargers. 20-10. Justin Fields looks good. There was some news from the Steelers. I believe it was... what's the guy's name? The Fatanu injury.
Rappaport?
Yeah, Ian Rappaport from NFL Media tweeted like overnight early this morning that Troy Fatanu, the Steelers' first-round draft pick, is now going to be out for the season. He's getting surgery, right? But they did say that he might be back if the Steelers make the playoffs. Oh, boy. Hey, you know what's weird, too?
Hey, not if, when.
Hey, you know what else is weird, too? I know this is like I'm not really thinking about it, and I'm not sure I agree with it. Doesn't Cam Sutton come back like later in the season?
Yeah.
And they have like a big suspension for like bad things. Like police were looking for him at one point. Yeah, but at some point, like over the halfway part of the season, he'll be like,
he's gonna reappear.
Oh,
yeah.
There's Cam Sutton. Just something to tuck away. Okay, don't think about it right now, but just something
just
to tuck away for later.
It's coming.
So Steelers 3-0 on the season. They beat the Chargers 20-10, and then Then we read the Facebook comment section.
Beware. We are going to a very deep, dark place on the internet.
Yeah.
Everyone is a GM.
Yeah,
everyone is a coach.
Yeah,
everyone is going to get traded.
Everything sucks.
It's time for Steelers Facebook comments.
These are Steelers Facebook comments after a 20-10 win against the Chargers and a 3-0 start to the season. Blaine G, they can win all the games, but they won't matter when it comes to the playoffs. They'll get knocked out in the first round. Wait a minute. Are we already there? We're already in the play, and we've already lost.
Oh, damn!
It's over. 3-0 start to the season.
Nothing to be excited about.
Somehow at 3-0, they've been eliminated from the first round of the playoffs.
Out of the playoffs already.
Steeler football. Randy R. Ruh-roh. Everybody excited over this team are the same people who are declaring Kenny Pickett a franchise quarterback after his perfect quarterback rating in the preseason. Tomlin will eventually ruin this season for all of us.
Oh, no.
Man, can you just be happy? Is there any joy in
your life, Randy?
Donald M. here. Don't matter. They'll crash midseason. Maybe just enjoy it. 3-0, Donald.
Randy and a Don aren't believing yet.
Vince P, no more small hands, two glove, bad attitude. Kenny Pickett, Justin Fields is my guy.
Moved on from Kenny.
Uh-huh. Rob J here, let Russ cook on the bench.
All right. I mean, Russell Wilson hasn't done anything to us yet, right?
All took was three games. Dave M. here in the Steelers Facebook comments after a 20-10 win against the Chargers. Two-game lead in the AFC North?
I don't know how. And I don't want to know how.
Okay, you know what? I kind of feel the same way. Like, hey, well, teams ain't looking too good in the AFC North.
It doesn't seem real. It doesn't feel real. Yeah. I'm okay with it, though.
Kevin G, in Justin Fields, we trust, man. I ain't been this happy since Big Ben was here.
Oh, man.
Don't say his name three times.
Don't say his name.
Say his name three times. He shows up to practice. We know how this works, right?
That's one.
It's like Yinz or Beetlejuice.
Uh-huh.
Don't say his name three times. He'll show up and just start throwing passes. Pete Z in the Steelers Facebook comments. Hey, another Harbaugh brother finds out what it's like to lose to the Steelers. Oh, that's right, because the other one coaches the Ravens. Like, all right, Harbaugh bros. This is how we get down here in Pittsburgh. Dave N., 33 years.
Oh, hell yeah.
Steeler fan.
All right.
This team, man, I remember when Big Ben started his first season. We are super team now.
We are now?
And week by week, we're going to look better.
Uh-huh.
I love my Steelers. In bad and good moments, I'm always with my team. You know what? Hell yeah, David N. David N, man, he's right. You know what? We are super team now. We are super team. I love how we go from...
You can hear the beers in that typing pattern, by the way. That's at least 9 beers.
David...
He's having a Sunday.
David N is 9 Modelos deep, and he's just like, hey, I'm in a good and bad moments. I'm always with my team. 33 years. And we will end here. One more Steelers Facebook comment. John L. Justin Fields is QB1.
Hell yeah.
Go Steelers.
Mm-hmm.
No reason to even consider Russell Wilson unless Justin Fields' arms and legs fly off. That would be tragic. It'd be tragic
be
if
something.
Justin Fields
That'd be really...
lost his arms. And you would have to put in Russ then.
I think they'd stop the game probably.
If Justin Fields takes a hit and it's just a torso left, I'm pretty sure Russ has to go in. By the way. Oh, damn! Gotta send him to the crossroads.
Oh, my goodness.
Back.
Arms and legs?
Yeah, it's the arms and legs of Justin Fields. There they go.
Like an action figure, you pull the arms and legs off.
This is how Russ gets in the game. And I'm going to miss arms and legs. And I'm going to miss arms and legs. I mean, did you think when you woke up this morning that we would be sending Justin Fields' arms and legs to the crossroads after a 3-0 start and a 20-10 win? I didn't, but here we are. By the way, the CBS pregame show that has J.J. Watt on it, they talked to T.J. Watt right before sort of the game started, right? When T.J. Watt had already gone through his warm-up, was about to go back in the locker room and everything. But J.J. Watt, hold on one second, brother. You're not going in the locker room yet. By the way, T.J. Watt and his wife, Danny, have announced that they are having a child, right?
Yep,
so
yep.
Here, that's the setup. Here's J.J. interviewing T.J. before the game.
All right. I know you're trying to get in that right headspace. I know you and Danny just announced that you guys are pregnant and expecting your first child. Me personally, knowing what that why means and knowing how important that is, I wanted to give you a little gift before you head back into the locker room to say congratulations on your new child.
Yeah, I gave him a number 90 Steelers jersey that says dad on it. It's for the baby, you know? So
yeah,
baby will have a Steeler jersey.
I wish you guys all the best.
Thanks, man. I appreciate you trying to mess up my headspace. I really appreciate it. I'm going to go back and lock in now.
10 sacks in 10 games after I had Koa. So I'm just saying, we've seen a lot of great things. We might see some great things.
We get it,
James.
We get it. Keep pumping yourself up. It's awesome.
Dude, so good. Man, you don't get stuff like that unless you're talking to your brother like that, right?
Right, yeah.
He's just like, hey, after I had my child, I had 10 sacks in 10 games. TJ's just like, hey, good job, James. Keep pumping yourself up there, bud. Good game by Justin Fields. He seems like he's pretty good with not turning the ball over, even though he had his first turnover in this game. He just sort of plays safe, right?
Yeah.
But when the Steelers run game couldn't get going in the first half.
I mean, first half was boring as hell.
Yeah,
it was.
That's when you go in the locker room and go, okay, well, they're saying, can Justin Fields beat us? And then in the second half, with some help, obviously, from the Steelers defense shutting down the Chargers, Justin Fields went out there and got the win. All right, so let's get to what Justin Fields had to say after the game. Justin, wait, I got to get the crazy frog music for Justin Fields, right? That's
yes.
How we do our Steelers recap here. All right, here was Steelers quarterback Justin Fields after the game on Izzy proving people wrong.
I'm not really worried about that. I'm more so into proving, you know, myself, you know, right. I know, you know, what kind of player I am. You know, I haven't changed kind of my whole life. So at the end of the day, my teammates helped me be great. So shout out to them. Shout out to our defense. Shout out to everybody else on the offense for pushing me each and every day at practice. And, you know, it's just a credit to them. So I'm definitely, you know, glad and just feeling good to be in this position, to be honest with you. So.
Oh, man. Steelers. There's just something that he's very monotone. He's very focused in, you know. He's not like a wild personality up there. So
you throw the crazy frog under him, though. It does something.
All right, here's Justin Fields on Steeler Nation showing up and showing out for the home opener.
I mean, it was great. Definitely a little bit different from preseason for sure. But the fans showed out, great turnout, and you know, it was awesome. It was definitely getting loud out there, especially when the defense was on the field. So great turnout by Steeler Nation for sure.
Oh man, that was Justin Fields' first experience.
I got a taste of the Renegade.
Regular season Steeler game. Oh, ...245 yards, one touchdown, and one interception for Justin Fields. And you know, I wouldn't say there's a quarterback controversy. I think even if Russell Wilson is healthy, Justin Fields actually threw the ball like quite a bit in the second half there.
He looked good, right?
Pretty sure he's your starting quarterback now.
Or is he?
I don't know. Who do you I hate it. I hate it. Just like, we don't make the decisions. You don't make the decision. You know, there's Coach Tomlin, a couple
you
other
got?
People. Who do you do you think if he keeps playing like? Yeah. No, I think if he keeps winning, they'll obviously go to Russ. Of course they're going to keep Justin Fields in if they don't lose games.